Union HRD minister must have just forgotten about such a case when he himself was the one who in fact had looked into these allegations in the beginning. Let me just go across to Abha Singh as of now. Abha, it's baffling that Kapil Sibal was the one who instituted that committee to look into that sexual harassment case. And then again, he was the one who appointed him as the vice chancellor. Do you see politics being played even at such sensitive matters?
I would not comment on the politics of it because I am not a political person, but I'd say that it was remiss on the part of the Human Resource Development Ministry not to present these facts.
Absolutely,
and
sir.
Consider them.
Absolutely. Abha, coming to you,
yes.
Do you see politics being played? Kapil Sibal was the one who initiated the inquiry. Then he was the one who gave a clean, who in fact made him the vice chancellor of the Vishwabharati University. Politics, even on such grave allegations and of a person who's been accused of sexual harassment?
Definitely politics was there because there were two set of reports, one which was instituted by Kapil Sibal and other was by the Bose Institute Governing Council. But politics apart, if we come to Padma Awards, a person who gets it should be above board. It should appear that he's above board. Nobody is questioning his academic excellence.
Absolutely.
But here when there was a charge as women harassment or sexual harassment, and at a point of time when we are very sensitive to women issues, I think the committee, it did not inquire into it properly. The rule says that the local IB and the investigative agency has to send a report, but generally it is seen that these IB officers or the investigative agencies, they do table investigation, they don't go to the grassroots. Maybe these facts were not put up to the Padma committee and that is why this has been given away. And I feel definitely if Padma Awards is too big an award, if there is an iota of suspicion, it should not be given.
Absolutely. Very quickly, Abha, do you feel let down that a person of such tainted past has been given the Padma Shri Award? Abha, if you can hear me.
Yeah, I can hear you.
I was just saying that do you feel let down that a person with such tainted past and a complaint of sexual harassment has been given Padma Shri?
Definitely, because now that it is being debated and the message would go that where you want to fix someone, you do it, but where it suits the government, it is, has to settle scores, it goes ahead. And when it is a women issue, at the time when women are being raped, women are being harassed and molested, and when one report said that there was sexual harassment, nobody is questioning the intelligence, nobody is questioning his contribution as a professor of physics and his contribution to physics, but if there was a complaint, it should have been looked into. Because Padma Awards are the highest, it should be above board, and this committee should come out on a report where that whether this report was had come to them or it has been given without looking into this factor. However, just it is said that against his appointment, they went to the High Court and Supreme Court, and the court threw it out. The PIL, it said this was a administrative matter. So when there is a grey area that whether it was a sexual offence or a administrative offence, this needs to be inquired. An inquiry must be done into the criminal aspect also.
Let me just bring in Mr. Roy from Kolkata there. So there was a series of letters that were written to the President of India. He, of course, is the Chancellor of the Vishwabharati University, also to the Prime Minister's office, as well as the National Advisory Committee by stakeholders of the Vishwabharati University.